Hello lovely people, welcome to the Geek Cupboard. I am Penge and welcome back to Before We Leave, where last time we spent pretty much the entire part sorting out our second island over here. Now originally it was called Island Number 2, which was a bit boring, but you know, it made sense, it was very logical. But then we stumbled across the fact that you can rename many things in the game. So you can rename the things at the boats, which we have done, but you can also rename the islands, which was very, very exciting. So away went Island Number 2, and in came Wee Hours Isle, which I do like. I like the sound of that. It's got a nice ring to it. So Dave from the Wee Hours, he's over here somewhere. He is overseeing operations over on Wee Hours Isle, which I think is lovely. I mean, he probably lives in quite a nice house. I imagine he's got this house here, because that's got the best views. Look at that. That would be beautiful in that house. So he lives over there, and he looks after Wee Hours Isle, and then I am over here looking after Cupboard Island. So I'm looking after the original sort of starter island. Dave is over looking after Wee Hours Isle, and that's how it's all going. So we've got our two islands, and over on Wee Hours Isle, it's looking okay. We spent quite a lot of time getting all this up and running. There's quite a few houses now. It's got a full sort of path system. A path goes entirely around the island, which is very, very good. And then, yeah, we've got ourselves up onto the rock bits up here, onto the cliffs. So we've got some industry going on. And the aim is to try and get this place a little bit self-sufficient, just so it can kind of look after itself in terms of the stone and the wood and the tools and all that kind of stuff, and the food as well. So that's what we're going to sort of look at today. We're going to see if we can make this place a little bit more self-sufficient, because they're doing okay, but I think we just need to do a little bit more work. I do notice there are quite a lot of these, I was going to say angry faces. They're not really angry faces. They're sort of just sort of, you know, glum faces, miffed faces, shall we say. And why is that? Too hungry or thirsty to work. And you hold over there as well. Peeps are resting from fatigue. Supply better clothing to fix this. Yeah, so in our research, we have been trying to get towards sorting out clothing. So if we go down to here, we've actually done quite a bit of research, and we can now research clothing as well. We've got enough red research. So we've got power last time, we've got glasswork, we got the house research done, so we can upgrade to housing. Of course, we've got shipping done as well. I think now, let's just get this done, shall we? Let's just get clothing underway right now, because that's what they need over on Wee Hours Isle. So let's just get that done, please. Research that. That should hopefully not take too long. So there you go. So we're down to 8 red research, but that should be fine. I think we'll be okay with that. Also, we have our scout ship over here. So we built ourselves a scout ship. This is, of course, the SS Yorkshire Gold. And this is just going around the planet, filling in the gaps. You know, it's filling in all the missing hex tiles to make a more complete planet, because at the moment we're still on this kind of sort of broken looking planet. So it's filling in the gaps, and it's looking for new islands and new places to go and settle, and it's finding all these other very interesting things as well. There's, you know, big sort of what were formerly buildings, I imagine, out in the sea. There's a boat there, just sort of a wrecked boat out in the sea. So this is just exploring. It's not a colony ship. It's not got people on it that are waiting to just, you know, jump onto an island and then settle down. It's just a scout ship. That's all it is. It just goes round and it just looks for things. So we'll keep that moving around as well. So I think the plan for today is we'll see if we can find ourselves another island and possibly locate another different type of research, because I have a sneaky suspicion that we've got the green research on Cupboard Island, we've got red research on Wee Hours Isle. I think on the next island, I think we're going to have a different colour of research, because if we look in here, if we have a look in the research thing, oh hang on, it thinks I've selected that. If we look in here, the research tree kind of ends here. We can't see what's going on, and it did that last time. It did that when we only had our original island. We couldn't see what was here because we didn't have the concept of this red research. So now, yeah, I think there are some different research colours on some other islands, and maybe more than one. Maybe there's two different sort of colours of research remaining. I do not know. We shall find out as we explore. And yeah, we need to make this island a little bit more self-sufficient. So we need to get the whole sort of clothing thing sorted. But yeah, also, what was that then? Too hungry or thirsty to work. Well, let's have a look here now. Let's have a look at what's going on. So they've got 20 water. So they've got plenty of water. Yeah, vegetables are lacking. Yeah, so it's food, really. They've got loads of fruit. They've got absolutely loads of fruit over here. They've not got much tea. Oh, well, this is an absolute tragedy. They need some tea. And yeah, so we can get them tea, maybe some vegetables and some potatoes. Just try and sort this place out. Just try and make it a little bit better for our residents on here. And of course, we could do as well with some more houses. because there's only 28 people on here, which is enough to cover the jobs right now. But as soon as we start adding things, if we had a farm, that farm's going to need workers. So yeah, it's not quite as straightforward as just going, yeah, right, we've built some farms, because then we need people to work on them. Okay, what can we do then? What about over here? Now, could we get ourselves a bridge over this tile here? So have a bridge going here, knock that down, and then put a road to here. And that means we have two green tiles over here, which is lovely. So we get two sort of farming things in here. That might be quite a good plan. Right, where was the bridge on here? There was a bridge somewhere in here. Whereabouts was it? It was in one of these. And I'm just going to keep clicking buttons until it appears. No, it's not that. It is... No, that's a marketplace, although we could do with one of those. Okay, where's the bridge? Oh, hang on. We just built a road, do we? No, we don't build a road. Where's the bridge? There it is. It's in this one here. It's in transporting and storing peeps and resources. So yeah, if we build a bridge just there, buildings must face a road. It is facing a road. Hang on. Can we not have it like that? Oh, right. Hang on. Maybe we need to remove that first. Right. Get rid of that, please. So let's move time on a little bit and let's get that sorted. So again, I've said this before. I do like the fact there's no imminent peril in this game. It's, yeah, our people are a bit hungry, but they're not starving to death. We're not going to start losing population, I don't believe. I think they just get a little bit glum. They're a little bit hungry and they're a bit fed up. Okay, right. Now can we get that bridge in place? Yes. Excellent. And then we can get a road. Oh, hang on a minute. Yeah, we need to actually get the bridge actually now constructed so I can put the road following from it. Okay, well, let's get this bridge done. I don't imagine it's going to take that long, is it? I don't imagine it's particularly heavy on resources. So if you could just, you know, you guys could just get that done absolutely right now, that would be great. But no, you seem to be taking a little while. You should have loads of wood. There's 24 wood. Why are you taking so long to bring some wood to this place? Yeah, we need some more people. I think we need some more people to do some transporting of goods around the place. Yeah, and this thing here means they're resting from fatigue. They're wandering through the desert and getting all sort of hot and bother. But there we go. Right. It is in, which is wonderful. Okay, right. So one and two just there. And then we could get ourselves a house at the end of here. So pop a house just there. We will then remove that forest just there. And then we will put a farm on that tile just there. So vegetables was lacking, wasn't it? So we'll get a vegetable field. I mean, you know, it goes against my better principles. I wanted to put a tea field in, but no, a vegetable field will do fine. Right, move this on then. Let's just get this done. And oh, they were playing the music from the house. I like that. I like the fact they play these jolly ditties. So let's see if we can get that done. And then I'd just be a bit happier that this is all sorted. Right, that's done there. And clothing research is complete. That is very big for the people of Wee Hours Isle. Okay, right. Ooh, we can grow a new thing. A cotton field. Oh, that could be good. That could be very good. Yeah, we're going to need that to make clothing, obviously. But yeah, we're going to need to make space for this stuff. There's not that much space over here in terms of green, lovely green fertile tiles. So, right, we'll see what we can do. We'll see what we can do. Okay, right. So we need some more food anyway, I think. I think we do need more food. So potatoes looks good. Yeah, veg. Veg just looks very sad. And then bread. Yeah, I mean, at some point we are going to be making bread. But, I mean, we haven't got the tech for that right now. But, yeah, that does keep cropping up. We keep finding it in boxes and stuff, sort of preserved from the past or whatever. Okay, so that's going to be a house. That vegetable field is in, which is very encouraging. Do we get another one of those in? Because that is sadly lacking just there. Let's get another one of those in. So another vegetable field. And then we've got a gap just there as well. Are we able to get something to just there? Could we get ourselves... Could we knock that down? So remove that and then put a road just there, a path, whatever it is, and then put something here. So we'll knock those down as well. So we come in and we just chop down all the trees because that's what we do. There's a space there as well that isn't being used for anything. However, is that a bit polluty? No, it's not. It's polluting that square, but not that one. So that's not so bad. Okay, yeah, maybe we could work our way around here. If we knock that down as well, have a road and a road, and then get ourselves something just there as well. Okay, right, we have a bit of a plan for this island. It's taking a little while to get those things constructed. That's fine. So if we come off of that, right, where's the boat? Where's the Yorkshire Gold? There it is. In order to populate this new island, don't forget you need a school. What new island? hang on, what? I've got a school. The numbers are going up. Thanks for that game. You confused me there. That was confusing. Okay, there's a big gap over here. Come over here, Yorkshire Gold. Let's fill in a few of the blanks. I love the way that that works. I think that's brilliant. The way they just sort of pop out of what presumably is the middle of the planet. I love the fact they just sort of fly out of the middle of nowhere. That is wonderful. Let's go to here then. This is going to be the bottom of the planet, isn't it? We're going to just sort of discover the pole. That's fine. We'll have a little navigate around the pole. We'll make sure it's all mapped correctly and stuff. There we go. Hello. Right. Bit cold round here. We don't want to settle around there. It's a bit chilly. We are going to definitely need clothing for that. Okay, there's a gap there. Oh no, well, right, that's sorted. Okay, so we've kind of got this bit done. So now it's going to be a case of going over here. So you go over to there, Yorkshire Gold. How is it looking over here? Right, we really do need to get clothing sorted because everyone is having rest. Everyone is fatigued. So we are going to need to get some of the cotton fields in. So we get a road there and a road there. I think, yeah, cotton field could easily go just there. And we've got space for one just there as well. And now here, do we put something useful, like a cotton field? Or do we put something that I feel obliged to put in and put in a tea field? I think our people might be a bit sad without tea. So let's give them a tea field. I've got two cotton fields. Oh, no, hang on. No, tea. There we go. Some lovely tea can go in. Right, the people are still resting from fatigue, but yeah, that they've got lots of stuff now. They've got a great deal of things, which is good. All these things down here are green and they're all happy, so that's pretty good. So we've got that sorted. There are a couple of tiles along here as well that we could use for things, so let's knock down those trees as well. I do notice there are two tiles here next to the existing houses that are green. I mean, we could put cotton stuff on them as well. However, we're going to have some sort of industry now for making clothes, I assume. Could not load ship as the port is full. Okay, I can't remember what you're shipping now. You're shipping some stone. Do you know what? You probably don't need to ship stone and stuff like that anymore because they're sort of okay. What have we got up here? I can't remember now. We've got an iron mine. And we've got ourselves a quarry. Ah, right. Okay, so we've got an iron mine and we have a quarry. We do not have anywhere that makes tools just yet. Do you know what? We might well struggle with getting a place that makes tools and not polluting other useful green tiles. This could be a bit of a problem. Do you know what? We'll leave you doing that for now. You go and do that. Although, do you know what? They don't need stone. Hang on, how do we adjust the shipping things? Just there. Right, manage shipping. Okay, they don't need stone anymore. I don't think they need wood either, to be honest. There is a person already providing wood. Do you know what? Our original isle is fine. So let's get rid of that. So don't take stone. They can do that. Take the research, take some tools, and take some wood. Because I think our original island is absolutely fine to make those things anyway. So there we go. So we'll have those there. Okay, so that's good. Did the boat get to where it was going? Is the boat? There's a thing. There's a potential new island. Come over here. Yorkshire Gold, discover land new. Is that new lands? No. It's just a few islands. Just a few little sort of rocky islands in the middle of nowhere. Okay, right. We can't use those. Right. You can continue your search, Yorkshire Gold. And while circumnavigating this pole here, I don't know whether it's the north or the south or whatever, but we have found a very interesting thing indeed. You've discovered a ruined spaceship, a relic of a bygone age. Your peeps investigating the spaceship wreckage think they'll be able to fix it up given time. Soon you could be sailing the stars as the ancients once did. Although, to be fair, it didn't turn out too well for the ancients, did it? Because they seem to have killed each other quite well. But let's have a look. That is brilliant. So yeah, it is indeed a bit of a mess. I mean, yeah, you're going to need to do some rewiring on that. And, you know, maybe use a hammer to do some fixing of things. But yeah, that does need a bit of work. But there we go. There's a little spaceship. Okay, that's very good. Okay, right, let's continue going around the pole for now. Just because I want to get this bit mapped properly and all of the gaps filled in. Okay, and now we have an island. So let's go over here. So is this big? Is this a great big landmass or is it a smaller landmass? No, it looks big. It looks big. What is that? What is that? Just there, there's a thing. What is that thing? An ancient ruin? Oh, there's exciting new things. Okay, right, come round this way. Come round this way, Yorkshire Gold. Let's see what else there is. Okay, there's another collection of things over there. Are they just on their own? Yes. Okay, right. They're just a little sort of island off the mainland. This looks quite big. It looks very big. Okay, yeah, this is a big island. Okay, right, let's try and get round the edge of it. Come round here, Yorkshire Gold. And have we nearly completed the island? I think we might have nearly completed the island. Okay, there we go. Right, so we can't see a bit just here behind the spaceship, but for the most part, yeah, that's quite deserty, isn't it? That's a very deserty island. Okay, right, we'll have to spend some time sorting that out. Right, let's just go and see if we need to fill in any gaps around the planet. Oh, there's huge gaps over here. Right, Yorkshire Gold, head over that way and fill in the gaps. But yeah, we definitely need to come over here. We're going to need to settle over here. However, there is still only red research. I wonder, however, now that we've found a spaceship, I wonder if that's unlocked sort of spaceship research or something. Right, where are we? Wee Hours Isle. Right, where's the thing? Everything's all confusing. There. That's the library. Has it unlocked extra bits? No. Okay, I thought it might have unlocked extra things over here, but clearly not. Maybe we need to settle on that island first, and then it will unlock extra stuff. Right now, though, 120 green research and 60 red research. Let's get cooking, shall we? Allows the construction of kitchens and smoothie makers. Why wouldn't you want to have smoothies? Who produce meals and smoothies, which makes peeps much happier. Kitchens and smoothie makers spread pollution to the surrounding tiles. Really? I suppose they're using energy of some description. Pollution from a smoothie maker? Yeah, okay. We'll have a bit of that, thank you very much. I kind of feel like we should get fountains as well, because they seem like a very easy, I imagine, pollution-free way of just making people happy, which is good. Okay, so there we go. So we've got a new island. Right, how are we going to get on with this other stuff? Because, yeah, I got distracted there. So we have all these new options, which we should have for making clothes. So what do we actually have now? What's that? That is the glass smelter. That melts sand into glass. Right, I've gotcha. And we have got a sand mine. Is that it there? So we do have a sand mine. So that's fine. So yeah, we've got actual piles of sand. What's that then? That is the tailor. Produces new clothing from cloth. That there weaves cotton into cloth. Okay. So where are we going to put ourselves? A weaver. Okay. Well, we've got a few choices. Can they go in the desert? Can they go in the desert? Oh, hang on a minute. We need to find a desert tile that's not occupied. Yes, it looks like they can. Although is that a yellow or is it a green? It just looks different. It looks like they can go there. Yes, I think they can go in the desert tiles, which is very, very handy. Okay, so do we... Yeah, we need to keep that space free, don't we, for this thing just here. Although we could build a bridge. We could build a bridge going that way, couldn't we? And connect that up. Is that something we could do? Hang on one moment. Could we build a bridge? No. The bridges go straight. They do not go round corners. Okay, so we can't bridge the gap between that tile and that tile because the bridges just, they don't work like that. Okay, that's a shame. Never mind. Right, so we can't build anything there right now. I feel like we need to get some of this stuff underway because we have ourselves some cotton now because we have our little cotton farms going on. So yeah, I feel like we need to get a weaver and then get ourselves a tailor. So we'll get ourselves clothing and we will get ourselves some cloth. Okay, where do we want to put these then? Where should we put these? I kind of feel like they need to come down. So knock those down and we'll put something useful at the end there. And then where have we got a gap? There's a bit of a gap there. Oh no, hang on, is that Paluti? Yeah, that's Paluti. We don't want to go near the Paluti tiles. That's going to be bad. Ah, there really is not very much room at all. Right, we might need to knock those forests down. Sorry, forests, but there's two of you there and we can build useful things on you there. That tile is part of the warehouse, isn't it? We have got a tile just here on the end doing nothing. So how about we knock that down as well? Just knock down all the trees. All the trees can go. Okay, so speed time on. That's now done. Splendid. And then let's get ourselves in here. Let's press the right button. Let's get that. So we'll get a weaver just there. And then I would say get a road there and there. So we've got two useful tiles at the end there where we could grow some more food or whatever. What are we running out of? Potatoes look a bit low. Vegetables are looking okay. And tea is looking low. That's not acceptable, is it? Okay, tea just there, please. And potatoes, because that's useful. So there we go. So a couple of extra bits there. And we still do need to get in a tailor. Clothing from cloth. Yeah, okay. How is this going to work? And what do they need? We need glass to build this. Oh my goodness. Right, okay. That's why we had all the glass stuff in. Okay, right. So a glass smelter melts sand into glass. Oh, it's really polluty. It's super polluty. Okay, I think we can put it there. And it doesn't pollute too much stuff. I think anywhere else, it's going to pollute quite a few more tiles. So we're going to have to put it there. That seems to be pretty spot on. Okay, fine. Let's put the smelter thing in just there then. Okay, right, good. So the glass smelter can go in. And then, I think we then place this down, the tailor. So then when the glass smelter is done, we can actually then get this tailor constructed. Oh my goodness me. Okay. Oh no, we don't want to put it there, because that's a polluted tile, so that's going to be bad. Where can we put this thing? Okay, can we chop that forest down? Have them coming through here. Could we get rid of something along here? Oh no, because that sand mine's there, isn't it? Okay, right, where can we put this other thing then? Oh, there's not that much room. Okay, here. Let's knock that forest down. So get rid of this forest, and then we will put in a, wherever it is, there. We'll put a tailor in that square just there. There we go, space cleared. So yeah, let's drop in our tailor just there. Now they're not going to be able to build that for quite some time, because we need all of these other bits and bobs in first. So that's going to take a little while. I think they're okay for everything though now. I think they're okay for food and all that kind of stuff. So they're becoming a little bit more self-sufficient. They still don't generate tools yet. They're still reliant on the tools bought over from Cupboard Island. But that's fine. Maybe we could just ship them the tools and that could be a thing that we always send them. I mean, I didn't realise, we saw this at the end of the last part, Cupboard Island is utterly massive. I mean, this could just generate all of the food that we could ever need for all of the other islands. And we could not bother growing little food things. We would just ship the food over on massive, great, big kind of boat shipment things. So we could just do that and then take away the food things over there. And then, yeah, just ship over the tea and all the other bits and bobs. So maybe that is what we should do over here. I mean, what we could do is, over here, we could put a road. Hang on a minute. What are you? You woodcutters? Oh, no, you're just houses. Oh, no, that's fine. So let's get rid of that forest and that forest. And if we drop a road into just there and then move time on nice and quick. Yeah, this island does not have enough people to deal with all of the jobs we're asking either. So yeah, we need some more houses. Well, do you know what? Let's upgrade that. And yes, and then upgrade that as well. You've started your first upgrade. I have not started my first upgrade. And the game has been updated. When I loaded the game, it did say the game has been updated. So I wonder if it's reset all of the little sort of tooltip notification things that are appearing up there. That would make sense. Okay, but now with that road in there, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 areas where we can grow some stuff. So how about over here? We could grow cotton over here. Grow cotton over here and ship it over to the other place. Oh, however, what's that? Workers' happiness drains slightly faster. I mean, we could make tea over here. That could be quite good. Why don't we have... That's a massive tea area. I mean, you know, we probably don't need that much tea, but yeah, what we're saying, you can never have too much tea. So, right, and then get rid of that wood there as well. And that, oh, hang on, are you a forester? What are you? Oh, you're an explorer. Yeah, okay, so we'll get rid of some woods along here. And then along the sides of the road, we can just have various farms. We do need some more houses. So let's get ourselves a proper house in there as well. And I don't know, what about one just there and one just there? Let's just get this place a little bit busier. So lots of tea, put lots of other farms across that side as well. So vegetables, bish, bash, bosh. Right, lots of things going on over there. So that'll keep them busy for a little while, which is good. Okay, right now, is there any more research we can do whilst we're here? Oh no, they're still doing the cooking research. They're still on the cooking research. Okay, so now... Do we want to make sure... How are the buildings looking, actually? How are the buildings looking? We've not got... Is that not complete yet? What's that waiting for? That's waiting for stone and tools. Okay, well, that should get there eventually. Yeah, that's going to be the holdup right now, isn't it? That's going to be the hold up just there. And cooking research is complete. We can make lovely proper things. We can make smoothies now, which is good. We didn't build a power thing over here, did we? We did not build a wood generator over here. Maybe we need one of those as well. I mean, how horribly polluting is one of those? Oh, hugely terrible. If we put it there, it's going to go over quite a few areas where we're growing things. It's not too bad if it goes just there. It'll get these tiles over here, but nothing is on those tiles. Maybe that's what we have to do. Just sacrifice a couple of those tiles over there to get this in play. Because, yeah, that's terrible, isn't it? That's very polluty. Okay, I mean, I don't think it can go anywhere else. I can't see it going anywhere else. Unless we stick it right out in the middle of nowhere. I mean, over there would have been pretty good, actually. But now we've put things in there. I mean, could we get rid of those two things and then just ship stuff in from Cupboard Island? Get rid of the tea field, which would break my heart. But then we can put the polluty thing over here and it won't matter quite so much. I mean, that's what we need to do. That's what we do. Generate power. Yeah, that's not going to get anything. It's going to get some road tiles. Do you know what? We're going to have to do it. Oh, bye-bye, T-Field. Are you sure? No. Must press the button. Oh, that wasn't easy. Right, okay. And, get rid of the potato field as well. Okay, move time on nice and quick. Let's get this done, and let's get this wood-burning generator thing in. Oh, Cupboard Island is slightly overpopulated. The peeps' happiness will drop quicker. Oh dear. Oh, that's not good, is it? Oh, we can't have that. Right, so put that there. And then we've got space here for something as well. For an industrial thing. What can we have over here that's any good? A smoothie. Ah! Smoothie maker. Can we put that over here now? And it's just not going to pollute anything. Yeah, let's drop one of those in as well. Why the heck not? Let's have one of those. Right, Cupboard Island. What's going on? You're overpopulated. What does that mean? Slight overpopulation. So 60 out of 60. So peeps are in 60, housing 66. That's fine, isn't it? Is that not okay? That seems okay to me. Okay, maybe we need to just leave it for a bit. Unless they've not got enough jobs for everyone to do. I don't know. I'm not entirely sure. What we are going to do is, however, let's go over to the thing just here, the shipwright. Let's get ourselves a colony ship. So we're going to need some tools. We can sort that out. So let's get ourselves a colony ship. Yes, please. And then we can get that to go over to the other island, the new island that we have discovered with the spaceship on it. And we'll try and set up shop over there and then get to work on the new island. We'll have to sort of do what we've done over here, but for that new one. But that's fine. We need the colony ship first anyway. And we have ourselves our very first glass smelter. And it's purple, which is unexpected, but that's fine. We can deal with that. Low power. Ah, right. Hang on. Is this constructed over here yet? No, that's not finished. So the glass smelter is ready. It's sitting there waiting, but we do not have yet our wood generator in. It's lacking some tools. Okay, right. Come on, folks. Let's get this done. And they are working on it, and it's complete. So the wood generator is now complete. It does then need to generate some power now, so let's just make sure they are going to actually put some wood in it to start generating a bit of power, and then we will have some power on this island, which is very, very good indeed. So okay, come on, spring into life, waiting for resources, just chuck some wood into there. There we go. And I think we are nearly at the point where we've generated some power. Creates 4 power every 10 seconds. Oh, okay. That's going to keep going on and off, is it? Is it doing anything now? Have we generated enough power right now? Okay, there we go. Right, a tiny bit of power has appeared. So now is this now powered for it to do its thing? So it's got some power and it's got some sand. So we should be making some glass, I would have thought. This might be a bit of a slow process. Waiting for resources. There should be loads of sand. They're surrounded by desert. Just go out with a shovel and get some. There we go. We are making 1 unit of glass. Finally, we've made a shiny new thing. The first glass has been made. That can then come straight down to here into the tailor, because that is waiting for lots and lots of things. It's waiting for wood, weirdly enough. And then have we put any of those things in at all? No, we've not put any of those things in, but maybe now we might get on with that. Okay, and then the tailor can then make some clothes. Then this island can have clothing, and that shall be very lovely indeed. We do need another house somewhere. We need another house, because there are not enough people on the island to do all of the bazillion things that we're asking them to do. Okay, can't put anything. Oh, yeah, we can put things over here now, can't we? We can put things here. However, we don't want to put a house onto the nice green tiles. Let's get rid of that. Get rid of that forest. We'll put a house just there. Someone could come and rid us of those pesky trees and that rock. There we go. Right, so put a house just there. Lovely. So that's some extra people living on this island. And the school is right opposite. So there we go. So yeah, that should get the population up a little bit. Hopefully that will then increase it to the point where everybody, all the sort of work areas actually have employees to go and work in them. I think we should get fountains research now too. It's long overdue. Our people are looking forward to having some fountains to look at and enjoy. And yeah, it makes the peeps happy. So I think we should do it. It's going to use all of our red research. So it's going to use all of the last 30 red research we have. I don't think there is any more red research left on Wee Hours Isle. So we might have to go over to the new island and then start getting the red research from that. But yeah, we've got plenty of the green research. There's absolutely loads of that around. So yeah, we'll get that done, please. We'll have some fountains. Why not? That'll make people happier, which is nice. And I think the Yorkshire Gold is about to complete the planet. I don't think there's going to be any other hextiles. And we've made some clothing as well. Oh, it's a historic day. Right, so fill that gap in just there. There's a gap just there where we've not explored. But I think, once we cover that up, I think that's it. I think we have ourselves a complete planet. I don't think it's got any holes in it anymore. So there we go. The scout ship has done its job. And this is what we've got. So we've got Cupboard Island just here. Wee Hours Isle over there. And then where's the new island? Kind of down here. Where's it nearest? Ah, right. Okay. So it's not too far away from Cupboard Island. Over this side of Cupboard Island, actually. So maybe we should get ourselves a port or something set up over here. And then we can start shipping goods over that way. But yeah, this island is going to need a bit of work. But yes, there's red research on that island. I can see it just there. And of course, yeah, there's that weird thing as well. There's that, whatever that was, sort of an old, what did it say it was again? An ancient ruin. An ancient ruin. Explore it at your own risk. Oh, we're absolutely going to go and explore it. Well, why put it there if we're just going to ignore it? That's just nonsense. So there we go. So we've explored the planet, which is nice. And there we go. It looks lovely. I mean, I will miss the sort of part completed planet because I didn't think it looked brilliant. But there we go. We've got a picture of the planet that we're on now, which is very lovely. Okay, scout ship. I don't really know what you're going to do anymore. I'm not entirely sure what your function is. Go and park up over there near Wee Hours Isle and just, I don't know, take some shore leave or something. Have a little break. Maybe over here on Cupboard Island, we build a kitchen to get some prepared meals. Because, yeah, on the little sort of food tab thing now, there's no meals. So they're really good over here. They've got some potatoes. They've got loads of water. Oh, they've got loads of water. They've got some veg. They've got plenty of tea. Very important. But, yeah, they don't have any meals. I think we should get a kitchen set up somewhere around here. I mean, it's unlikely we're going to do anything over here. So how bad is a kitchen going to be to set up? What on earth is going on there? We haven't got enough tools, have we not? We've only got one tool. Oh dear, just one hammer just lying around somewhere. Okay, yeah, that's not encouraging, is it? Where was the kitchen? Somewhere along here. Just there. Cooks meals from ingredients. Eating meals makes peeps much happier. How polluty is it? Oh, it's not that bad at all. Oh, I thought it was going to be all sorts of terrible. But okay, no, that's fine. We can work that. We can make that work. Just put a path going around the island like that and then put the kitchen just there. That's absolutely fine. Yeah, okay. We'll have one kitchen, please. Oh, and we can have fountains as well. What a joyous day. Okay, let's have a little look. Brings joy to all who are near. 10 tools. 10 tools to build a fountain. Good grief. Okay. Do you know what? Let's put a fountain in the middle just here, because this is a very popular area. So we'll drop a fountain in there, and then, I mean, the warehouses probably see quite a lot of use. Are we able to put a fountain somewhere around here? And I suppose, can we put a fountain in the desert? I don't suppose we can. No, that would be nonsense, wouldn't it? Okay, where can we put a fountain? It doesn't look like anywhere over here really suits. Oh, just there. There we go. Look, anyone wandering on that path can enjoy the fountain as long as they get to the right angle. Do you know what? Yeah, we'll throw that in. Yeah, they've got 65 tools over here. Also, again, not enough people. Need another house. Okay, let's plop one down somewhere. Given that we have very few tools over here, I think maybe we should get ourselves another toolsmith in. And again, they're quite polluty, but if we stick it up on here on the mountains, I don't think it matters too much. So yeah, let's get ourselves another toolsmith, please. We'll have another one of those, if I can remember exactly whereabouts they were. Okay, right, a toolsmith. Produce other resources? Is that it in there? A toolsmith. Yeah, just there. That makes perfect sense. Great big kind of industrial area over here. Right, get that complete, please, because, yeah, that's not good, is it? Having no tools over here, that's got to be bad. Also, why is that? What's that elevator is busy? Okay. Why has it got a red thing on it? Is it overworked? Is that elevator too busy? Hang on. Right, we could rectify that. We could sort that out. We could put a bit of road there. And then, if I can remember where elevators were in this big list of buildings now, we could put another one in just there. Just to reduce the load a little bit. So we've got a bit there, a bit there. Could we put one over here as well? Just to sort of see if that works. Yeah, we could put one there, look. That connects up and then that road could connect up to there. And there we go. So right, so we've got multiple elevators on this side as well. So that should help out a bit too. So taking a look at the trade route thing that we've got going on, they can't ship any green research anymore because Cupboard Island doesn't have enough green research. It's all gone. I guess we've shipped it all over to Wee Hours Isle. So we'll clear that out of the way. So say, right, don't bother doing that. And yeah, they've not got enough tools. They're taking up to 15 per trip. So don't do that. And then in terms of wood, I mean, how do we do this? I don't want them to just take wood forever. At the moment, don't do anything. Trade ship, just sit there for a bit. I mean, we'll see if this all goes wrong. If it all goes wonkaloids, then fine, we'll readjust it back. But there you go, for the moment, let the trade ship just sit there and let us try to get some tools back in and just sort of develop up Cupboard Island for a moment. One thing we haven't got is a marketplace. Makes luxury items to bring peeps joy, and it looks like all it needs in the marketplace is some wood and some power, and that seems to make jewellery. And I'm not entirely sure how that works, but I will absolutely roll with it. So I think we get ourselves a marketplace in. So I don't think it does any polluty stuff. Oh, it's a funny shaped thing though. Okay, I mean, could we put it there? Hang on, is there anything polluty around there? No, it would fit quite nicely in just there. If I can find where it was in this list of things. Oh, where was it? There's so many things. In there? In that one. There it was. Marketplace. Yeah, what if we put the marketplace just there? It's not near anything that's going to pollute it. And that might be quite a good thing. That might bring people joy and make people happier over on Cupboard Island. We're still struggling for tools, but they are using the tools to build lots of other things. They need tools over here to get the other toolsmith in. In fact, you know what? Let's make that more of a priority, please. And then they've got tools over here going into the elevators. They've got tools going into the sort of colony ship thing. Tools going into the kitchen. So yeah, they need an awful lot of tools. Oh, and into the fountain as well. So tools are an absolute premium thing. So yeah, this poor toolsmith. The one toolsmith. Oh no, there's three of them. The three toolsmiths are working very, very hard. It's probably a very stressful time for them. But that's fine. I mean, we can keep sort of transmogrifying some stuff over here because we're pretty good on getting loads of wood. We've got quite a lot of that going on. So we'll keep transmogrifying and we shall get all these buildings constructed and then we'll have loads of tools. We will have absolutely loads of them. Ah, that is interesting indeed. So the Explorer's Hut over here on Cupboard Island is now saying there are no resources available. And I've had a little look around the island and I cannot see any spots where there's any green research left. I don't think we have any research left for our explorers to go and find. I don't think it's connected by roads. I don't think it's connected by anything. I think they have exhausted all of the research available on this island. So I think what we could do is now, we could demolish this, get rid of this, because currently it's got a worker in it. It's got Irene. Irene is working over here in this place, which is a bit pointless because Irene is doing utterly nothing. Irene could be better placed going to do something else now. She could transport some goods or she could build or whatever. So how about we get rid of the Explorer's Hut? So yes, please. We will demolish that because it now serves no purpose at all. It does not do anything at all. So there we go. So that frees up Irene to go and do something else, which is good. And there we go. So yeah, we've sorted. The only thing is, if that's it then for the green research, How much green research do we have left? 162. Is that all? Is that all? Is there any green research on island number three, please? Wherever that might be. Where is island number three? Oh, this place is very befuddling. Island number three. Where are you? Show yourself. There. Is there any green research on here? Or is that it? There's certainly red. That's a forest. That's red research. So ancient red research stuff. And red. And red. Can't see any green. Maybe that's it. Maybe the 162 green is all we've got. Maybe that is it. And you know, we have to now ship all the green research over from Weehour's Isle over to here. Now, how is our little colony ship thing doing? I know they were. Oh, it's so nearly complete. It must need... hang on. Is it done? No, what does it need? It needs one tool. Just a screwdriver or something. Come on, somebody. Somebody just come in. Did you bring the final thing? Finally, though, we do have the second toolsmith set up. So hopefully we should see a rapid increase in the amount of tools that we have available. And we can get rid of all of these arrows here. Saying no resources available. Because we've got currently 4 things that are requiring tools that we can't complete. But hopefully all those things will go away. In fact, I think that's going to go away very soon. Here comes a fountain to bring joy to our people. Let's have a little look. The colony ship SS Almost Sunk. Do you know what? That's actually quite a good name. that's actually a very good name. Okay, it's finished as well. So now we only need tools available for the market over here and the kitchen over here. Right, okay. So the SS Almost Sunk. I mean, we don't need to rename that because it's not going to be around for very long. Right, it's more over this side, isn't it? The new island. Where should we set up? I mean, if we set up here... Set up just there. That means we can get some shipping in from, say, over this side. There's some quite nice green tiles there where we could start getting ourselves some fruit and veg and what have you growing over there. So yeah, there, I think there looks pretty good. So come over here. In fact, can we just click and colonize just there? No. Okay, right. So the ship has to sail over. Might take a little while. Oh no, there it is. It's on its way. Let's just help it along a bit. And in. Yeah, okay. I'm all for setting up shop just there. That's absolutely fine. I mean, yeah, the spaceship is over there, but it's not too far away. So, okay, we will colonize I mean, which way around does that even need to be? Like that? Just there, please. So there we go. And now we have some people over here on island number three. And again, we can rename this. So I don't think we should call it island number three because that is terrible. That's very dull. So welcome everybody to Bristly Land, which is of course managed by my good friend the Bristly Stranger. So yes, him and his great big bristly beard are going to manage this third island over here. And this could be very important indeed, because this is the one with the spaceship on it. We have found the spaceship. Ruined spaceship. Can we repair it? Yes, we can. So it's not beside a road. So we're going to need some wood. That's fine. Can do that. Then a mystery resource that we've not quite uncovered yet. It's going to need some glass. We could ship that over. Tools. Yep, absolutely. Stone. We can move that over. Food and water. Yeah, they're a sort of given. And then some power as well. But of course, yeah, it's these two mystery resources that we do not know about yet. I mean, I'm going to guess one of them is steel, because I think we do have some sort of steel research available that we've not quite got around to yet. So I imagine one of the things is going to be steel, because that, I mean, yeah, that sort of looks metal-y. It's got metal-y parts on it. I mean, it kind of looks a bit like a barrel, which I do quite like. But yeah, it's going to be steel, but then what else? I do not know. I don't know what else there's going to be over here. But there we go. So we've got our little people stood over here in Bristly Land, which is very lovely. So yeah, we've got, what have we got? 5 people. 5 people and no houses right now, which is, yeah, we're going to have to start working on this. So get some houses in, get some very basic sort of food infrastructure in, and then set up a trade route to get some tools over there. And then, yeah, over on, hang on, we can, there's arrows. Oh, well, that's a lot easier, isn't it? Why don't we just use the arrows? Over here, is it worth us getting ourselves a tool sort of smelter thing over here? Because we do have iron. We've got an iron mine. But I don't think we're doing anything with the iron. I think we're just, I don't know, looking at it, sitting on it, using it as pillows or something. I don't know. Maybe we need to get ourselves a tool sort of toolsmith over here and they can start making their own tools over in Weehour's Isle. Because at the moment, we're not shipping any over. They're not using any either. But it might be quite handy for them to be able to make their own. Although, to be fair, they've got 54 tools and nothing much is happening over here. So maybe that's not so bad. Maybe that is not so bad. Right, they're fatigued, so they'll get better clothing. That's fine. That will happen just by virtue of, you know, just time passing and them making clothing. We've got cotton just there. I mean, maybe we put down some more cotton farms over that side. Maybe just put one more down just there, say. Just get that in. So that's another cotton farm. So that would give us three. So plenty of cotton for the person to turn it into cloth, for then the tailor to turn it into clothes. So, you know, that's all good. We do need another house now, it seems, over here on the Wee Owl's Isle as well. Yeah, let's just drop it into that little gap there, into that little sort of, that little crevice just there, the little nook and the cranny. Okay, so there we go. So Wee Owl's Isle, I think, is looking okay. It's looking okay over there. They've got a kind of smiley, happy face thing. How they're doing over on Brittyland? Yeah, okay, a sort of an average face. And Cupboard Island, smiley, happy face, hooray. Okay, so things are looking very, very good. Oh, hang on. Are they building the market? Is that actually being constructed? I wouldn't mind seeing that being finished, because I'm intrigued as to how this is going to work. Come on, somebody get in there and finish building this, would you? It's almost done. And our kitchen is finished. A little notification popped up, but I sort of almost missed because I was looking at something else, that said that our meals have been made. Our first meal has been made. And there it is. It's our little kitchen. That's very lovely. It looks very pretty over here, surrounded by all the forest. I can see why it does actually create a little bit of pollution. You know, it's kicking out a little bit of smoke there, isn't it? A little bit of smoke is being produced from this sort of chimney thing just here. That's lovely, though. You could make... what are they called? Like wood-fired pizzas, whatever they are. You could make them in there. That looks very nice indeed. I do like that. That looks very, very good. Is the market done? The market's done as well. Yay, the market is complete. Although people were a bit sad. People were a bit sad about that. Okay, well, that's fine. Don't be sad. The market's here. Hooray. It looks like they've made some stuff as well. Yes, they have made a few bits and bobs. But there you go. So we've got a little sort of trading area just here. Little area for trade. There's a... I don't know what that is. A green thing. Yay for the green thing. And then you've got a little area here where you can have a little sit down as well. Oh, that is very lovely. Look at that. Some little seats where you can go and you just, you know, take the weight off your feet and just sit at the market and enjoy a little bit of peace and quiet. That's very lovely. Okay, so we've got all these things in. It's looking good at Cupboard Island, although they're not quite as happy as they were a little moment ago. But never mind. How they're doing over at Wee Owl's Isle, they're absolutely delighted. And then, of course, over in Brislyland, that did not take us to Brislyland, that was the sea, we have a bit of work to do. Because, of course, our people are over here. We've got ourselves five people over here, but there's nothing going on here at the moment. But yeah, this is going to be very important indeed. This is where the spaceship is. So yeah, this island is going to be pretty key. And of course, it does have this mysterious ancient ruin on as well. We can go and explore that next time as well. And I think what we'll do is we will indeed finish up for the moment. And then when we come back next time, a lot of effort is going to go on to Brislyland. Because I think the other two islands are fine. I think they're able to sort of, you know, look after themselves. So we are going to need to ship some food and water and stuff in over here to Brislyland. But that's fine. We can get that done. And then also as well, we are going to want to move in all of the green research that's over on Wee Owl's Isle over to here as well. But again, that's something we can do, and we shall do all of that stuff next time out. Hopefully you are still enjoying this. I think this is very fascinating indeed. I'm intrigued to see now where we go from here, because we have discovered this world, I suppose. We've got this island, and then this entire world has been revealed to us. So next, I guess, is the spaceship. Might take a little while to get that done, but then I'm intrigued as to where we go from there. What happens then? Do we pick a planet? Do we crash on a planet and start all over again with no research or what? I do not know. So yes, I am very intrigued as to how this spaceship is going to work, and I'm looking forward to finding all that kind of stuff out. So yes, I hope you are enjoying all this. If you are, then please do leave a like. That would be very, very splendid indeed. And also, if you are not already, then please do subscribe in order to keep up to date with how we get on next time out here in Before We Leave. But for now, thank you very much for joining me in the Geek Cupboard, and I will see you next time. Right, if we connect to there and open the door, we're going to get vaporized by this laser. And there's an electronic thing, which looks like a sad kind of Game Boy. I'm a tiny little sort of stick person in a computer. I can't steer the train as such. And look, we are outside. And we're in a gutter. Oh, happy days. Hello, Leaf.